Hi everyone, John here. I'm outside Abbey College here in Cambridge and I'm going to give you a quick tour of the building. Now, obviously it's lockdown here in the UK still, so it's going to be a little bit quieter than normal, but hopefully you'll get a good sense of the school. Okay, let's go and have a look inside.
Hey guys, this is the boarding team. Hello. This is the main building of the school, which we call Block A. And this is where we teach most of our academic subjects. So subjects like physics, maths, humanities, art, chemistry are taught here. And just in front of me now, you can see the building here. This is our on-campus accommodation called Abbey House, which we prioritise for our younger students between the ages of 14 to 16. And as I pan round, you can just see Block B, which is our other main building. And this is where we teach subjects like economics, business studies, biology and academic English. This is our common room. This is a space that students can use outside of their studies to relax. And you can see we have a small library in here, some seating for students, some printing facilities, and also some computing facilities as well. So this is really a social space for students, but they can also use it to do some work and just to relax in generally.
Okay, so I'm now in the dining room here at Abbey College Cambridge, and obviously food is a really important thing for our students who come and study with us. Most of the students who live within the college boarding have a full board meal plan, which means that they have breakfast, lunch and dinner 7 days a week that's provided by the college. And the meal variety is really, really wide. We provide a different menu each week on a 4 week rotation, and there are dishes from all around the world. So the idea is we're providing meals that our students recognise and they're familiar with, which is really important when they first join the college. We want them to be healthy, nutritious and delicious meals and good fuel for them. We also have a little coffee bar, which is just behind me. So students can also grab drinks, grab snacks outside of the main meal time. So if they're doing a bit of work after school, or if they're taking part in a club or hanging out with friends, they can grab a snack, grab a drink, grab a coffee. So it's a really nice space for students to eat and also socialise in. Okay, now we're in the dining room. Let's go and take a look at some of the on-campus boarding here in Abbey House. Okay, so we're in Abbey House, which is our on-campus boarding house here at Abbey College Cambridge, and like all of the boarding facilities here in the college, it's segregated by gender. So that means here in Abbey House we have girls' floors and boys' floors. And this floor which I'm on at the moment is actually a boys' floor, so all the students who live here are boys. Let's go and take a look at one of the single rooms so you can get an idea of what they look like.
You can see some of the features of the room. It has a standard single bed. And fresh linen and fresh towels is provided every week. There's also storage underneath the bed and storage above the bed as well for things like books. Students have a study desk and there is a Wi-Fi which is available for access to the students. Okay. Each room has a window which opens up. You can see this one's open at the moment with a lovely view over Homerton College, which is one of the colleges of the University of Cambridge. And there are also filter blinds so students can filter out the sun, and blackout curtains, which enables you to get a good night's sleep.
And finally, each room here in Abbey House is ensuite, so that means it has its own bathroom. So you can see as we go into the room, you can see this room has a basin, a toilet, and also a shower cubicle. Okay, so that's a quick look at one of the standard single rooms here in Abbey House. We also have other types of rooms. We have a superior room, which is a bit larger, and we also have a twin room, so students can choose to share together if they want. Let's go and take a look downstairs and have a look at one of the common rooms that students can use. Okay, so we're now in one of the common rooms here in Abbey House. Each floor has a common room like this. Remember, the floors are segregated by gender. So there are probably about 25 students on each floor, and they get to share this space as a communal area. So an area where they can relax, an area where they can come together, they can hang out, they can play games. There's also a kitchen in each room so they can do some basic food preparation like make tea, coffee and toast. These are really spaces that are designed for our individual students. So the house parents will put the equipment in that the students want. So if a student is particularly interested in music, we might have musical instruments. If they like games, there might be some games in here, and things like PlayStations and consoles as well. So it's really, really a space for the student to come and relax after a day of lessons. Now we're going to move through from the boarding to the school itself. Okay, let's go. So here we are in a typical classroom here at Abbey College Cambridge, and what are the features? Well, first and foremost, it's a small class. The average class size here is about 10 students. The biggest class you'd be in would be about 14 students. And that means that there's a lot of interaction between teachers and students in the class. You can ask questions and get the answers that you need, and there's a lot of participation. Our students are quite ambitious, quite academic, and they challenge each other in the classroom, and that's something we really encourage. Secondly, we have these teaching walls behind us. So you're actually able to write on the walls. We don't have one whiteboard. Most of our classrooms have at least two. This room actually has three writing walls. So that's really important because it means that the students can apply their knowledge. They can write answers on the walls. They can try to solve equations in mathematics. They can work in small teams. What we know, and this is more than true for international students, is if you can have a go at something and try it, and if you get it wrong, rub it out and start again, you're more likely to attempt it. And by having a go at something, you learn better. The classrooms also have large e-screens as well, which act like a giant iPad. Teachers will put their lessons up there as well. And quite often when we're doing homework review sessions, we might ask students to post their homework up there for discussion. We quite often give the students laptops which are enabled with the screens. So we use the technology to really encourage this participative class environment where students are challenging themselves and each other. So the classroom is a really, really inspiring environment here. Okay, so even though the third floor is predominantly for mathematics here at Abbey College, Cambridge, we also have these rooms up here. And these rooms are actually music performance studios. Music is a really important part of our extracurricular program here at Abbey College, Cambridge. We have over 60 weekly clubs and societies that take place. And extracurricular clubs are really important because they allow students to relax outside of their studies at the end of a long day, but also universities really like students who have a wide range of interests outside of their studies. Okay, so that's the maths floor. Let's go downstairs and take a look at some science and some humanities. Okay, so I'm now on the first floor of Block A here at Abbey College, Cambridge, and as you can see, it's very similar to the maths floor in terms of the layout, but here we do quite a different range of subjects. So behind me where I've just came from, that's our humanities department. So that's where we teach subjects like history, government and politics, English literature and geography. And where I'm walking just now, this is our chemistry department. So this is where we teach one of our main science subjects. So let's go and take a look at one of the labs. Okay, so here I'm in one of the chemistry labs. We actually have 12 laboratories in total here at Abbey College, Cambridge, where we teach physics, biology and chemistry. Each department has its own dedicated lab spaces. And you can see it's still a small class environment, but here the focus is very practical, so lots of experiments. We have things like the fume cabinets here in chemistry, and a lot of practical equipment that enables students to conduct experiments, both that they'll need to as part of the A-level or GCSE syllabus, but also we go above and beyond that here at Abbey College, Cambridge. We do a lot more experiments that are beyond what we would traditionally study for the syllabus. So really nice practical spaces for our students to get hands-on with the scientific subjects. Okay, so just continue our little tour here on the first floor at Abbey. We've just been into the chemistry labs. Above us actually on the second floor we have our physics labs. We have four physics labs up there. Where I'm heading now, just on the first floor, is over to art and design. So let's go and take a look in the art studio. Okay, so this is our art studio. We actually have two art studios here at Abbey College, Cambridge. It's one of our newer subjects. We teach art at A-level and GCSE now. We have many students who study physics and maths who maybe want to be architects, and they need to do that creative subject to develop that portfolio and that creative thinking. But actually, since we've been doing art since 2016, we've had many students interested in things like interiors and things like fashion, creative, pure arts. So it's really, really a growing subject for us here, and we have some lovely facilities. Okay, so we've taken a look at Block A. Let's go over and have a look at Block B. Okay, so this is our study over in Block B, and this is a space that students can use much like the common room, but as the name would suggest, this is a bit more of an academic study focused area. So students can come here outside of their lessons, and they know that it's a quiet space where they can do some studying and some revision. Our staff do monitor this space as well so that they can be assured that it's nice and quiet. Some of the younger students, some of the GCSE students, might also have timetabled sessions in here where they're supervised by staff. We call them study skills sessions. And for the year 12 and year 13 students, this is a space that's open to do their own self-directed study. So just a nice space that they can use. Okay, so we're here in Block B, which is the smaller of the two buildings of the college, and we're on the first floor, which is home to business studies, economics and accounting. So let's go and take a look in one of the classrooms. OK, Okay, so I'm standing outside our biology labs here over in Block B. Biology is one of the three core sciences we teach here at Abbey College Cambridge. They're all very popular with our students, physics and chemistry being the other two. The biology facilities, much like the chemistry labs and much like the physics labs, are very practically focused, nice, light, airy, small class size spaces that students can do lots of experiments in. That's really the emphasis here with our sciences. Biology is also key for our students who want to go and study at medical school. We have a very, very strong medicine preparation program here at Abbey College Cambridge, and biology is key to that. So our prospective medics spend a lot of time in these laboratories. And finally, here in Block B, this is a space that I know our students like to use. We have a small gym. So we have some running machines in here, some rowing machines, and it's a nice space that students can use for their leisure and fitness outside of their lessons. And behind me, just over my shoulder, you can see our hall. So we use this space for lots and lots of different things. Assemblies, clubs, fitness classes, music, concerts, movie nights at the weekends. It's a lovely multi-purpose space that we can use. We also use it as an exams hall as well, so it's a space where we can run our end of year exam. Well, I hope you guys really enjoyed that brief tour of the campus. We have an amazing facility for students here in Cambridge. We have over 50 classrooms and over 400 bedrooms for students, both on and off campus here in Cambridge. But of course, what really makes the school so special are the students who study here and the teachers who teach them. So we really hope to see you in person in September.